Let's get these guys to work.
We good? Check, check.
Sometimes it's easier to lay down, but the floor's all wet, so.
All right, guys, well, that was a drive. We finally made it out here to paradise.
Hey, guys, it's Ben Goheen over at the Neighborhood Plumber. We are in the North Georgia Mountains in Cleveland, Georgia, looking at a home that was built in 1980, and they've still got some polybutylene in the home. In case you guys don't know what polybutylene is, it's a big word. It's also some bad piping. So back in 75, 78, they created polybutylene, turned out to be a bad pipe, and a lot of homes still have this pipe and are experiencing pinholes, failed fittings, leaks. Some of the polybutylene that you can look for, one of the most common things to look for is the gray color of the pipe. Gray pipe isn't really used anymore in plastic pipe like this, so if you have any of this gray piping in your home, chances are you have some polybutylene. So this particular customer, I've kind of educated them a little bit on polybutylene, but they've got a leak in their crawl space and they're really not budgeting repiping or getting rid of all the polybutylene. So we're going to crawl under this crawl space. We're going to do a quick repair where this leak is, and we're going to use the famous SharkBite Max polybutylene transition couplings. So a quick look, and we'll get under here and check this out. All right, guys, we made it under the home. We've located the leak, as you can see. I want to talk a little bit about the SharkBite Max transition coupling. So just to kind of give some perspective, you see the gray, it almost matches the gray on the polybutylene. Smart concept. The gold side is going to be what's going to connect to your expansion pipe, PEX A, PEX B, copper, CPVC. The gray side is what's going to transition from the polybutylene. There is still a stiffener inside of the polybutylene side, so you definitely want to line it up with your polybutylene, make sure it's nice and even, and give it a good push until it slides and bottoms out. The insertion depth on the SharkBite Max is going to be 1 inch, so make sure to look at the insertion depth chart that SharkBite offers at their website. So with the SharkBite Max polybutylene transition couplings or fittings, they're going to come in 1/2 inch, 3/4 inch coupling, and they'll come in 1/2 inch, 3/4 inch elbow, making it super easy to get these polybutylene repairs taken care of quick, fast, get the customer's water back on. So today we're gonna do the repair on a 1/2 inch poly line, and we're going to be measuring for a 1 inch insertion depth, which is how far the pipe is gonna slide into the fitting. One thing I want to just mention, you know, as a plumber and doing a lot of repairs under homes, with making a polybutylene repair, it's quick, it's easy. All I really need to have is my 2 SharkBite Max transition couplings, a pair of SharkBite pipe cutters, piece of SharkBite expansion PEX pipe. I did bring in a tape measure. I did bring in a pair of mini channel logs, plumber's best friend, and a deburring tool. After we cut this polybutylene, we're gonna deburr it. And once we cut this PEX pipe, we're going to deburr it. We're also, I brought a Sharpie so we can get our insertion depth marked. And should be a pretty quick, easy process, and I'll be sure to walk you through what I'm doing along the way. So we're gonna go ahead and cut out a decent section. I always like to cut, you know, a decent ways away from the break. Obviously, this portion of the pipe is defective, so we wanna try to get onto a good portion of pipe. When cutting the polybutylene, you don't wanna just squeeze. You wanna gently squeeze and in a twisting motion so you don't squeeze the polybutylene, cause a crack that could cause another leak. So we've cut this side. I've got some water in this pipe, so I'm gonna try to get it over here. And I am going to take my SharkBite deburring tool. I'm gonna find my 1/2 inch port and I'm gonna give us a little deburr. So this is a directional tool, so you wanna make sure that you're going the right direction clockwise. Same thing here, we're gonna go clockwise and deburr both ends of that. I'm gonna go ahead and deburr my PEX A. I'm gonna deburr this end, and then I'm gonna make a cut on the other end. And once I make my cut, then I'll deburr the other end. And we will cut in a twisting motion. We will spin this clockwise to deburr. So now that we've got everything deburred, I like to prep the SharkBite on the pipe that I'm going to be repairing with. So I will
go ahead and get my insertion depth marked. And while I'm here, I'll go ahead and do both ends. SharkBite Max is going to be a 1-inch insertion depth, and I'll go ahead and come up and mark my polybutylene with my 1-inch. And mark this side with 1-inch. Now, if you're watching this video, you don't want to blink because this can be repaired pretty quick. So we're going to make sure to use the copper CPVC or PEX A or B side. We're going to press it all the way on our pipe till we hit our insertion depth, and we've got the gold end on our expansion PEX A pipe. I'm going to do the same thing onto my polybutylene. I like to twist the polybutylene as I'm pushing my SharkBite Max coupling on, just to make sure that that pipe stiffener fits into the polybutylene. All right, so we're gonna take our adapter, same thing on this side. We're gonna kind of twist in a circular motion while we push to make sure that that stiffener goes in the center of that polybutylene. We're gonna take our PEX A. We are gonna push it all the way in and make sure that it is bottomed out with our mark. So I'm noticing in this crawl space, some of these straps are breaking. They have been here for a very long time, but this home is on a well, and with the well kicking on and off, may have caused vibration that caused that strap to break. Could have caused some of the issue with the leak, just depending on all the factors that happened when this leak occurred. All right, guys, we got some clamps. We call them J-hooks. We're going to get this one strapped up on our expansion pipe. I'm gonna take a hammer. They come with these nails. And we'll add one more down here on our poly. All right, I think that'll do it. Just to give a quick recap, we're in and out already. We came in with, you know, minor tools, couple tools, and couple fittings, and got this customer back up and running. SharkBite, the technology they use and how they connect and transition to these fittings is really huge. You know, there's many other ways that this can be done. A lot of the other ways take more time, require more equipment or tools. And also they compromise the structure and the pipe of polybutylene, which is the biggest problem with the pipe. So with SharkBite's fitting, it slides onto the pipe, it locks down, and it does not interfere with the integrity of the pipe. Hey guys, for any of the products used in today's video, check out SharkBite.com or click the link below. We'll see you guys on the next one.